So today I am making a new video on these two little braids. It's really simple, but I think it's like the cutest little hairstyle. Everybody that I usually like do their hair, especially my sister, like they love this. So I'm gonna show you guys how I did it. And the good thing like about this hairstyle is like you can do it with like any type of hair. You hear me talking about it in the video, but also sorry about the lighting. Like right now I'm still trying to figure out where I'm gonna like film my YouTube videos and everything, so right now I'm trying to deal with light because I don't want to use my ceiling light because it's like this orange tone that's like really ugly and it makes me look like even uglier. And so right now all I have is my makeup light on. And I mean, it's bright and it's like showing, so like it's pretty good. But in like certain clips, like right now, you can't really see the braids. But I'm gonna insert a picture. But yeah, let's get into the video.
Hey, so I'm like editing this video right now, and then like on this clip right here, I noticed like I'm saying a lot of things in Spanish, like I say liguitas, also known as hair ties. I just have to put it out there because, like, if you don't know Spanish, I'm talking, like, just, like, if you know Spanish. But, like, yeah, they're just hair ties. And, yeah, sorry.
Okay. So, a couple things you are going to need is water. I have a spray bottle. Liguitas. And a big liga. You can use liguitas, but I have to take care, so I need a bigger liga. And I use gel. So, I probably like a brush if you need to brush your hair. Oh, and a pencil. People use combs, but I personally like pencils better because they're sharp and they get like the thing right. And like I've never been able to get a part with like a comb or anything. Like as hard as I try, I can't. So what you're gonna do is like put your hair back, and depending on like how big you want your braids, you go off. Me, I have a widow's peak, so I go off like the ends of my widow's peak, like over here. A widow's peak is this part right here. For those that didn't know, I have pretty good friends in my family. And so you just run your fingers back. If I'm looking that way, it's because my mirror's right there. So. And this is, you just grab this piece of hair, and then with a comb or
a pencil, how long do I know? You just part it like how you want it. Like, so you have sharper parts, technically. Like that. And then on the other side. This is like the number one thing, like, everyone always asks me to do, like, even my friends. Or they'll, like, ask me to do a regular, like, French or Dutch braid, but I'm just like, I'm pretty sure people know how to do those. I mean, these are pretty easy, too, but since I'm pretty good at these, I decided to do this one. I'll probably be doing a lot more, like, hairstyles because, I mean, so you're gonna grab the rest of it and put it up. I know my part looks super weird right now.
So you just put the rest up. And you flip it back. And I had my hair parted in the middle today, so mine like automatically split. But if you want it like even better, just split it in half. Okay, so now you're gonna have these two parts, and I just tie one up real quick so I can start with the first one.
So you're going to wet it, and yeah, I kind of like, I personally like it, like when it's actually like actually wet, because it gives me like more of a grip on all the hairs. And then I recently started using gel. Like at first I wouldn't use gel, but I started using gel for like people's braids and all that. And they love them because all the little hairs stay in. So like here I got my gel. I put like the tiniest amount. Like ever. Oh, you can see that because it's clear. So okay, it's just like a tiny little drop. And I rub it into these two fingers. And then I go in and try to do all the braids. That's how I break it. Drop the hair. Okay, and then for this part, there's like different ways you can start it. You can start it in the middle, towards the outside, or towards the middle. My sister, I usually do this on my sister. She personally likes it when I start in the middle, so that's what I'm gonna do right now. So it's just a Dutch braid, and that's just when you get three pieces, and you just keep putting each end piece into the middle. I usually just do like a couple, just like pieces of like regular braid, and then I start adding the sides in, just so that the front has like the extra detail of the braid. And you just keep doing that. And make sure to like tighten it, so that you can really see it. I would turn on the ceiling light, but it's like the whole, like the most horrible light. Like, I need to switch out the light bulb. Cause it's like those yellow, orangish lights, and I hate those. Like, it looks even worse. So there's like not too much light right now, but if you're not able to see the braid, I'll probably take pictures of it.
And it just really depends on how.
Okay, so my phone ran out of storage, so I had to like stop and clear some. So I already am done with this one braid.
Okay, now just repeat that same thing on the other side.
I feel like I'm not going into depth with this, but it's just like it's simple. Well, no, I can't say that because I think it's simple because I'm always doing it and like I know how to do it. So, you know, I'll explain it slower. So, like I said, just let your hair. You're like when your hair's like actually like wet, it's like a lot easier to handle it. I want to put it. It's a lot easier to like do it in general, just because it's not like sliding out of your hands. So it's, well, that's just my hair. It's pretty soft. Okay, so you just get the three parts, and every time you're just gonna put the outside ones into the middle. So that one goes into the middle, and this outside one goes into the middle. Then you tighten, and it's just like a regular braid. Well, I start off with a regular braid, and after that, you put it under. I see people do this differently, like, they'll grab the hair and then go up and put it under. I put it under first, so I have, a hold of it. And then I come over here and I grab the piece of hair that I'm going to put in. And I put it in, like that, under. And you tighten. Now you just take it to the other side.
You just keep putting hair into it. And that's pretty much what a Dutch braid is. A Dutch braid is just going under. French braid is going over. So how I'm putting the strands under, that's what makes it a Dutch, and you can see the braid on the top. And with the French, you just put it over. So it's, you can't really see the, I'll probably do like, I know what to do for like another video. I'll probably show you guys like the complete difference. Cause like my friends will be like, oh, can you do my hair? Or like, can you do a braid on me? And I'm like, French or Dutch? And they're like, what's the difference?
So I'm just like, there's a difference. So, you just keep doing that.
Okay, so that's the braids. You probably can't see them, but I'll most likely insert a picture so you can see them better because my lighting is like really off right now.
And right now what I'm gonna do is my baby hairs. And I was like, I might as well do them too. So what I do, I put my hair back. Just so that, like, because I have, like, some that are, like, grown, like, some that are longer than aren't necessarily as baby, but I still fix them. So I do that so that they can hide under the hair that's going to come down. So I get some gel and a toothbrush. And I just brush them down. Just to tell you guys, I've never used this toothbrush. I literally just got it to do my ears. It's not like having it on and off and stuff. So like you see, some of these are like out front. Like they're not as baby as, you know, baby hairs are supposed to kind of be. But then everybody has like different baby hair. So then I take them out like that. And I dip the toothbrush into some gel. I usually put it like on this little thing that I have right here. So that I can just like dab it on there. And then I just go down. And usually I like to separate the pieces that I know I'm gonna want, because if not, they'll like all go in together. So like this would be one. So what I would do is brush down, like towards my face, and then just put them towards the back. Like that. And grab some more. Depending on like the hairstyle I'm doing, that depends on like how many like little loops I do on my hair. Cause like right now I have all this up. Usually I have like at least like another two up here, or like one. But how I have it up, I'm just gonna do two today. Like that. And usually I would do these little baby hairs, but I'll tell you how I have my hair wavy today. I don't think you're gonna want to. That's the thing, like they have like their off days. As like, just like any girl that has curled their hair, they know there's that one strand of hair that doesn't ever want to curl. And it's just like sometimes, like the piece of hair will like change. Yeah, you see. Cause like this one, it's longer. It's like more like sideburn, not necessarily a baby hair. So I have to tuck it into the back of my ear for it to look right. And sometimes it just doesn't want to work out.
So I went ahead and did the other side off camera, and there's always that one side that comes out like looking nicer than the other side. That always happens to me. It's very frustrating, but these didn't come out as good as I wanted them to. But yeah, that's the hairstyle. So that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I feel like that's the weirdest thing to say when you're talking, but okay. So comment below if you guys want me to do like other hairstyles. I know I have most people that I know on here, so like if you guys know like any hairstyles you want me to like put on here, just like comment or like text me and I'll do them. So yeah.